The work that we do here is very important because it keeps the communication open between Russia and the United States.
Here we implement various treaties and communication systems 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
We're working holidays, we're working Christmas and Thanksgiving and 4th of July.
Things can happen at any moment and we're constantly on alert.
We're really in the crisis prevention business.
The Nuclear Risk Reduction Center is a communications center here in the State Department that operates to communicate with countries around the world where we have special treaty relationships, where we are communicating to implement arms control treaties, whether it's a strategic arms reduction treaty, now we have the New START treaty, or a conventional treaty like the Conventional Forces in Europe treaty.
The role of the NERC is very important because we are an interagency resource. We support the entire U.S. government in all matters pertaining to arms control and international security communications.
The NERCs were established to help exchange arms control information, to help prevent any misunderstanding, to help prevent any miscalculation, to help prevent any misinterpretation of something like a missile launch, so that we know when the Russians are going to do a test launch or the Russians know when we're going to do a test launch.
The NERC is active, supporting over 14 different treaties and agreements in 6 different languages, including the Convention on Armed Forces Treaty of Europe, the Chemical Weapons Convention, and most importantly, the New START Treaty. This is our main NERC Watch Center, where we monitor all treaty communications. Here we would have communications officers monitoring communication circuits back here. We have watch officers monitoring various conventional and strategic arms control treaties. And this giant video wall allows our watch officers to work collectively together and to share information and notice when new and urgent information is communicated to the NERC. The NERC transmits or receives over 7,000 treaty notifications per year, and that translates into roughly 15,000 government-to-government messages per year.
One of the notifications that we receive is when the Russians inform us that they will be testing one of their ballistic missiles through a launch. So what happens is a communications officer will receive the notification, pass it off to a bilateral watch officer, will translate it, create a DSM cable. This is reviewed by the front office and then transmitted by the watch officer. The communication goes to a number of different parties, including the National Military Command Center, as well as other interested parties here at the Department of State.
Hello, this is the Nuclear Risk Reduction Center. Yes, this is Beth Harper.
Well, I know I can always count on the NERC because if I have a requirement in the dead of night to get in touch with the Russian Federation for some reason, the NERC is available no matter what, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and that is why it is so important. It's in some ways similar to the hotline that has existed since the Cuban Missile Crisis that allowed the two countries, at that time the Soviet Union and the United States, to always be in touch between the two leaders if a nuclear crisis arose.
On September 11th, when the network goes down, this was the only network that we were able to communicate with the Russian president.
The deputy secretary came and requested NERC send a goodwill message to notify the Russians that we were increasing our defense readiness condition. And he wanted to let the Russians know that this was not directed toward them and it avoided any misunderstanding.
The New START Treaty has an extensive series of notifications that are really going to keep track of what's going on inside the Russian strategic nuclear forces as a missile moves from a production facility into deployment, as it goes from a deployment site on a base into maintenance. All of those moves are going to be notified, so they will be passed through the Nuclear Risk Reduction Center. The notification regime is one of the core foundations for the verification of the New START Treaty. Without those notifications, we're not going to get the picture of the Russian strategic nuclear forces that we would get otherwise. So the NERC is key to the implementation of the New START Treaty.
In my Air Force career, I started as a missile launch officer. So I knew what it meant to go to work every day with the possibility that I was going to launch my missiles towards our enemies. Working here at the NERC, is very rewarding because I have a chance to help make sure that we never have to launch those missiles.